Welcome to this first webinar of the BIM Workflow Week through the eyes of a structural engineer. So this week is organized by Gretec. Our objective during those five webinars, so one webinar per day, is to have a journey with you on possible BIM workflows dedicated to structural engineers using Autodesk and Gretec programs together. Few words about myself. So I'm Joseph Pais. So I am a structural engineer working for more than 20 years on the construction industry. And today I will present you the how to create BIM models using Autodesk Revit and how to send them to Advanced Design to simulate your projects and synchronize back all the changes, all the optimizations you can do back in Revit. So the agenda of my presentation today. So first, I will start with a short presentation of our Advanced Power Pack and Advanced Design, just for you to have a global overview of what we are talking about. So what are the programs, the Gretec programs, the Gretec softwares involved in this workflow. Then I will we will go through the BIM workflows, and I will explain you what we can do, and then the live demo to show you in live an example of integration between Revit and Advanced Design. So Advanced Design, what is Advanced Design? So Advanced Design is a 3D FEM structural finite element software dedicated to structural engineers. So Advanced Design is clearly that part of an open BIM workflow. So you can link Advanced Design with Revit, that's what we will see today, but you can also link Advanced Design with Advanced Deal. You can import in Advanced Design several open BIM formats like IFC files, SDNF files, SIS2 files, and so on. Advanced Design has international design codes, so the Euro codes, with several appendix all across European countries. But Advanced Design includes as well the North American codes, so Canadian and United States codes. So Advanced Design, as I told you, is a FEM software. So Advanced Design is able to run FEM analysis, different kind of analysis, linear analysis, dynamic analysis, non-linear analysis. It's a fast and easy to use software. That's the feedback from our users with, for example, several automatic load generators. So 3D climatic load generators for wind and snow loads, a generator to generate seismic spectrums according different codes. So we have also traffic loads, moving loads, so several loads generators included in Advanced Design. So Advanced Design has a multi-core mesh and FEM engine to be able to calculate fast big models, especially when we import from Revit an entire BIM model. And Advanced Design is not doing only FEM analysis, but it's also doing including modules to design reinforced concrete, timber, and steel members, including steel connections as well. Advanced Design is also able to run capacity design checks. That's a specific point when you have frames under seismic actions. And of course, around all those calculations to produce automated reports, including tables, detailed formulas, views, post-processing views from the 3D model. The other software I will use today in this demo is the Power Pack, our Advanced Power Pack for Revit. So our Power Pack is what? It's a plugin that exists in different flavors for Revit, for Inventor, for Vault, and for Advanced Steel. Today, I will show you the Power Pack for Revit. And the idea of the Power Pack is to provide to a Revit user daily tools to speed up the modeling, to speed up the processing of the BIM model, the tagging, so many functionalities for the daily use of Revit to make it easier to use and faster to manage your project. So as examples, and I cannot list here all the functionalities in the Power Pack, we have around 70 functionalities dedicated to the daily use of Revit, but among the most important ones, we can mention the Family Manager to enhance the user's ability to manage the Revit families. The join and unjoin geometry, which is a very powerful command to automatically manage the intersections between structural elements, as we can see here on the picture. So managing the intersection between walls and concrete floors, for example. So you can join and unjoin geometries on selection, define your rules to automatically manage those geometries. A numbering tool, which is very powerful, to renumber an entire model, to renumber a model on selection. Again, defining the criteria, how you want to renumber. So you can renumber different kind of elements, including grids, levels, structural elements, ducts, doors, and so on. And you can really manage the way you want to order from X plus to Y plus to Z plus. So you can really renumber very fast, very quickly, an entire Revit project. The link to Excel to create an interactive bidirectional link between your 3D model in Revit and Excel spreadsheets. So to import in Excel some data, to modify this data, and to synchronize back the changes in Revit within a single command called link to Excel, which is part of our power pack for Revit. The element lookup, which is also a very interesting feature, especially when you use, for example, the element lookup with the numbering, for example. So the element lookup gives you the possibility to select on multiple criteria, to select elements in the 3D model and to quickly perform a search, a query on the model, even if it's a complex 3D model with users' filters. Okay, and the last point I wanted to mention is about Rebar. So the Power Pack has, as you can see, some transversal tools dedicated to all Revit users, so architects, structural engineers, map engineers, but also some specific tools dedicated to Rebar design and detailing. So we can generate 3D design-driven rebar cages that we will see during this presentation and use reinforced concrete detailing tools to tag automatically some Revit views that can be also created automatically out from the 3D model. So you can place the tags, place the annotations, and get drawings much faster than using just native Revit functionalities. Okay, so let's now switch to the demo. So now what I will focus on for my presentation is to show you a workflow where I will start from Revit. I will export the 3D Revit model to Advanced Design, run, perform a 3D finite element analysis, and then store back results, FEM results, theoretical reinforcement values in Revit to be able to automate the creation of the 3D design driven rebar cages. So let's switch to Revit. So this is the Revit model I will use. So I prepared this model for the presentation. So as you can see, it's a model including reinforced concrete structural elements, columns, footings, slabs, core shear walls here in the middle of the building. So I prepared, when creating this Revit model, I prepared also the analytical model where I applied some loads. So here we can go to the load cases and we can see that some load cases have been created. So dead loads, live loads, and two seismical load cases as well for X and Y seismic directions. I have applied in those load cases loads. So here, for example, we can see in the live load case, a load with 1.5 kilonewtons per square meter. So I created those loads, cases and loads that I applied on the reinforced concrete floors. Also something specific that I did because I want to perform a seismic calculation in Advanced Design, just considering for bracing the core shear walls. So I defined the reinforced concrete column as released at the top end. So I defined here on the analytical description of the columns, bending moment for the top release, as we can see here on the property list of Revit. So the idea now is to take this 3D model and export it to Advanced Design. So when you install the Power Pack that I described just before, you get the complete ribbon here with all the functionalities that I mentioned, few of them, the link to Excel, the element lookup, and so on. And here at the beginning of the dedicated Advanced Power Pack ribbon, you have the BIM Connect. So the BIM Connect, the idea is to be able to export files, to import files, to synchronize files according to some settings. So here on the settings, you can define if you want to map the sections, if you want to export and import loads or just geometry. You can also filter the export to only export elements with the analytical definition. So if you are a structural engineer and you don't want to export everything, just export the structural elements that are important for advanced design. So you see that you have some options to manage how you want and which data you want to export to advanced design. Also here, if you are using Advanced Design and Revit on the same computer, you can use this icon, Advanced Design, directly from the Revit ribbon to have a flash link to Advanced Design. If not, of course, you can export a file that you can store everywhere. You can store on the server the file created and ask your colleagues to import the file on their computer. So depends on the situation. So here, I will use the flash link. So as soon as I'm clicking here, so the Power Pack is performing the export of the model. I am able to create a log file, which is important, you know, to follow the data. So here you have some information about the date, the time, the files, and the number of elements exported. Okay, so I'm arriving in Advanced Design. So as I told you, with all softwares on the same computer, you can use this flash link. So it's loading Advanced Design automatically, and then you get the 3D model, as we can see here on screen. So here I am in Advanced Design. What is important is that we get the geometry, obviously, as we can see here, but you get also the model organized as in Revit. So for example, we can see here the load. So we can see the four load cases described in Revit, dead loads, live loads, and I can see the loads. Okay. So a load in Revit becomes a load in Advanced Design. So an object load, with its intensity that you can change, if needed. So you get the existing loading coming from Revit in addition to the geometry. Regarding the geometry, so if I'm just, hiding the load, so, we see the geometry. So we have the footings which were converted into punctual supports in Advanced Design. But you see that, for example, here you still have the geometry coming from Revit, which is important. So if I'm back in Revit, we see that the type with the dimensions are imported in Revit, in Advanced Design, so which is quite useful if you want to design elastic supports, for example. Okay, so and of course you get the structural columns, the slabs, and so on. So here we have the organization of the model per systems, per levels, let's say, which is quite useful if you want, for example, to display, to isolate only, you see the last floor and work on this floor. So that's what I will do now, for example. Here, so I will set just a transparency here, okay, to better work on the model. So maybe one question that you can have yourself in your mind is, okay, that's great, this model is perfect, it's going from Revit to Advanced Design and is well aligned. This is true, but what is important for you to keep in mind is that either in Revit, in our Power Pack, okay, in Revit, we have some tools here, you see, we have some dedicated tools to detect the errors on the analytical model, and we have here some tools to trim or extend elements, to stretch to nodes. So we have some tools to adjust this analytical model. So Revit has also some native tools, but we have added some additional tools to manage the analytical model in Revit. In case you are importing other BIM files, not necessary from Revit, for example, or if the engineer wants to tune the analytical model in advanced design. On advanced design side, we also have some tools to control the model and to also automatically extend two axes which are not well connected, to project elements on the plane if they are not exactly on the same plane, to automatically stretch to a node. So we have also some tools to adjust the analytical definition in advanced design directly. Okay. Here I'm displaying the model in 3D, but you can change. You see the way you display the model. So you can display, for example, on the axes, which is sometimes more easier to really control that all the elements are well connected. Okay, so let's come back to our model. So here what I will do, I will create on this last floor some beams, because here we see that we have a flat slab directly supported over columns. So I will decide to create some beams. So here I can add some elements. So I'm adding a linear element. So in advanced design, when you create an element, you have a property list where you can check all properties of the element. So no need to open several dialogues. You go directly from the property list. So here I will create reinforced concrete beams. So I will just assign a section, and I will create those beams just from example like that, you see. So what is important is that, for example, let me just hide the slab, it will be easier to model. So here you see that when you have some continuous beams like this one, you just create a single element. You have also the possibility to, so we have some CAD tools to, for example, to copy like that, just taking the snap points and making copies with the mouse. So you see that it's very fast, very easy to model in advanced design. Also, if I'm putting back the slab, you can select, for example, those elements. So I can select per section. Okay. And those beams that I created here, I will offset the beam so I can define the direction. So, to the bottom to the bottom, and do not consider this offset in the structural calculation. So here you see that I have created some additional beams here on the model. Okay. So let me display back the entire model. Now what I will do before running the calculation, I will also define the seismic spectrum. Okay. So for that, I will just select here the area. So myself, based in close to Paris, I'm using the French appendix of the Eurocode 8, but depending on your country, you will have your map. So I'm just selecting one area. I will define the category of the building, and I will just set a few other parameters like the behavior coefficients on the two horizontal directions, and to get automatically the corresponding spectrum generated by advanced design, as we can see here. Okay, so last thing I need to do, I need to create a model analysis to run the dynamic calculation. So defining either the number of modes I want to calculate or the maximum percentage of masses you want to reach, I define the masses. Okay, considering all the entire dead loads and the part of the live loads like that. Okay, and defining some other coefficients to only calculate the horizontal seismic direction. So including the automatic definition of the damping depending on the materials. Okay, so when you have done this, just few changes, you know, to the model that I imported from Revit. I will just generate the combinations because in the Revit file, I had only the load cases, not the combinations. So I'm generating the combinations. As you can see, we have automatic combinations, and then I can run the calculation. So let's run the calculation. It will take a couple of seconds to be performed. So as you can see here on this first part, we can link using the Beam Connect from our advanced power pack. We can link the 3D model from Revit to advanced design, so including the entire analytical model. Yes, by the way, I didn't show you, but We can check that the boundary conditions on the columns. So advanced design is also getting from Revit the hinges or the fixed. So in fact, all boundary conditions you are defining at the extremities of the elements. So now the calculation is done. So advanced design is just saving the results on disk for a faster post-processing after. And now we will see how to post-process the model. And then that's the core of the webinar, of course, how to export back all this data, including the new reinforced concrete beams I created to the 3D model in Revit. Okay, so the calculation is finished. And I will show you the how to post-process the values. Okay, so here, when the calculation is done, you have a dedicated ribbon to post-process the results. So I can, for example, display for the X seismic directions the displacements of the building, so I can rotate around the building, as we can see. I can, when I have a post-processing view, I can save the view, so the view will appear here on the browser, and you can really save different kind of views. For example, here you can define, you can decide to display the bending moments on the beams, on the columns, for example. You can define values as well. You can increase, you can zoom just on a part of the building, for example, and again save the views. And you, each time you save a view, it appears here on the model. So you can quickly, you see, switch from a view to another one. So for example, here on the first floor, I can just isolate the first floor here, you see, and for example, decide to display the resultant forces, so the bending moment for X, or for, let's change it, for the Y seismic directions. And here you see I have the bending moment, the resultant of bending moment values. I can increase a little bit the size. Okay, and you can see here the values directly on the shear walls. Okay, so again, you can save this view here on the browser. So you see that it's very easy to post-process the results in advanced design, save the views, and include, why not, those views into reports. Okay, so now what I would like to do, so let me put again the entire model on screen. So also you can run the design. So for example, if I just filter the last floor, so you can decide to calculate the values, the theoretical reinforcement values on this slab. So I can select the slab, I can go through the property list as I told you and define some parameters, for example the steel utility class, the concrete cover, the exposure class. So the exposure class is coming with some cracks verification done automatically by advanced design. And by the way, here I have an option to automatically correct the theoretical reinforcement values to fit with the maximum cracks with imposed by the Eurocode. Okay, so when I have set this, I can run the reinforced concrete calculation. Okay, yes, only on this model. So here, for example, I have a message saying that I should increase the concrete cover values. Okay, and I can, for example, post-process cracking values. So here you can see the cracks on one direction on the slab. So you have the value. So of course, here it's perfectly fitting with the maximum because I imposed, I checked the automatic calculation of the theoretical reinforcement values to fix with the limit. And what is interesting is the reinforcement values here, and we can see, so let me just change maybe the units to have smaller numbers, maybe easier to read. Okay, so we can see here the values per mesh, 7, 0.05, 4.75 centimeters squares per meter. So I have the theoretical reinforcement values over the whole slab. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to export those values to Revit. So for that, I first here I can manage. So what do I want to export back to Revit? So here, for example, I will check this option to export the theoretical reinforcement values calculated in Advanced Design and to also export forces on all nodes. For example, if you want to export a model to Advanced Steel, you can export only at the extremities and intersections of steel members to design the connections in Advanced Steel, for example. So it really depends on what you are doing. So me, I will export everything. Okay, and I go to the beam ribbon where you see all the possibilities of beam workflows with Advanced Design. So I told you at the beginning, IFC files, SDNF files, SIS2 files. So you can import, export those different formats. And here, me, I will export a file called GTCX. It's a work file. So I will call it results AD. Okay. And I am saving the file. So now it's taking a few seconds because the system is exporting the geometry and the results as well. So let's wait while it's finished. Okay, it's done. And now I will go back in Revit. So I'm getting back to Revit. Okay, and in Revit, in the power pack, again, in the Beam Connect here, in the power pack ribbon, we have the possibility to synchronize a file. Okay, so I will not import because I don't want to overwrite my Revit model, but I want to synchronize the changes. So I'm clicking here into synchronization. So now, I have this dialogue. So this is a totally new dialogue. So this new version of our synchronization mechanism will be released with our version 2022 in May. So I'm showing it to you. It's a preview of the version coming, where you can open a file. So here you see I'm loading the file that. No, it's not this one. Sorry, it's not this one. Yes, it's this one that I just generated now here, results AD. Okay, so I will open this file. So the grid, the matrix will be filled. So it's we have changed this matrix. Why? To make it much easier to use and to better control what you want to do. For first thing here, you see that on the model that I loaded, so here you have the file. So this is the results.ad, it's the results.ad.gtcx file loaded at that time. So I know how many new objects I have, changed objects. I see that here I have some results. Okay. And here you have a grid. So you have some options to filter which results you want to import, the name of the result sets. You can rename the results packages. You can filter the very quickly the columns, which columns you want to take into account to add or to delete. So you see that you have a lot of attributes you can synchronize. It's very easy. You can also just click there. You see, if you right click, you can display, hide the columns, or even filter here to see, for example, only the new created elements. So here you see that I see the new created elements that I created. I have some informations, you see some more details. And it's very easy to synchronize because you really control what you want to synchronize and when. So here, for example, I don't want to synchronize the entire model. So I'm just filtering on new created elements and just those six new beams that I'm selecting, I will decide to keep to the initial Revit file to accept the changes or to ignore. Okay, so I will accept. So you see that it's doing it for all. And as soon as I will click on OK, it will apply the changes to the model. Okay, I can again save a report. So it's applying the changes to the Revit model. Because I also activated here the results package importation, so it's also importing the firm results and the reinforcement values directly to the Revit file, and we will store it in Revit as Revit results packages. So let's just wait a couple of seconds. Okay, so it's done. Okay, and now, first thing, so that's good because here I have the analytical view of the Revit model. So here, if I'm go, sorry, I will close it. So here, if you go to analyze to the results manager, first thing you see that you have the set of results stored coming from Advanced Design and stored in Revit for seismical forces and theoretical reinforcement values. So here, if you want, you can explore, for example, the forces and display the, for example, the bending moments values. Okay, doesn't want this on the model. And what is in important is that now why to store those values here, those results. The idea is that now if I'm going back to the model, so first you see that, let me show you in this view, you have the beams which are been imported directly from Advanced Design. So you see a single beam with the right type, obviously, or a continuous beam through, you know, with the three spans, okay? If I'm going to this view where I'm just filtering to see the top level, what is interesting? So I have the geometry synchronized back in Revit. That's the first point. And the second point is that when I'm selecting a column, okay, for example, I can go here and import some, I can use those results. So for example, I will use those two sets of results. Yes. So now it's loading the results, and you will see that what's the idea behind is to be able to automatically use those forces to automate the 3D rebars creation. So for example, if I'm selecting a column, now I'm showing you it quickly, but we will go more in details in the next webinars this week. So if I'm going to the loads over this column, on this column, you will see that we have some loads here, as you can see, coming from the Advanced Design model. Okay, and this is very useful. Why? Because now, suddenly, selecting a structural element, defining some reinforced concrete design assumptions that you have in Revit. So that's our design modules running on top of Revit. You can select, for example, you can select three columns. You can design those columns. If they are identical, you can even group them. You can create families of identical elements. And you see that when you run the calculation, it's designing and generating automatically the 3D rebar cages on those columns. Yeah, so you see, and it's of course Revit native objects, reinforcement Revit objects. Okay, you can do the same with the beam. So either this single beam here that you can calculate. Why? Because I imported from Advanced Design all internal forces to calculate this isostatic beam, for example, or even the continuous beam here that I imported from Advanced Design. So you see that you can very quickly generate 3D design-driven rebar cages within the model, within the Revit model. Okay, thanks to those forces imported from Advanced Design. Also, last thing, okay, I am out of time, but I will take 5 more minutes if you agree to show you that for the shear walls, that's very interesting. So let me, for example, hide those elements. Okay, so here, when you have also shear walls or a wall, so this one, for example, I defined it not as a shear wall, but as a bearing wall because it has an opening. So again, you have all the loads, all the internal forces coming from advanced design, so you can calculate and get the 3D reinforcements on the wall, on this wall. Of course, depending on the reinforcement assumptions you are defining for the elements, and you see that you can get very detailed 3D rebar cages automatically, either on a bearing wall like that, or if you select a shear wall like that, again, depending on the reinforcement assumptions you have. So I will not go in the details, but you have the possibility to define several reinforcement assumptions. Depending on the values coming from advanced design. So here we see the internal values on the dead loads, live loads, and seismical load cases. We can, again, run the calculation, design the shear wall, taking into account all the Eurocodes seismic dispositions, and generate automatically the reinforcement on this element. Okay, so and so you see that then you can do it very quickly and get all the details. Good. So now I would like to come back on my presentation. So this was just a first view of what we can do. I invite you really to connect to the webinars coming, so the webinar from tomorrow on Tuesday, so by Peter. So Peter will go even more in details and will show you, for example, how to reinforce a concrete slab as well, using the same approach. I'm getting theoretical values from advanced design. I'm automating the rebar in Revit. So Peter will show you. We'll go more in the details of this. On Wednesday, Stevens will show you even more details about the detailing functionalities, how you can split the bars, how you can create bars around an opening, how you can tag, how you can generate and tag views. So we are going further on the detailing capabilities. On Thursday, Michael will be more focusing on BIM workflows for steel, especially showing you how you can link with advanced steel and design standard and complex steel collections. And finally, on Friday, Adriana will close this BIM workflow week, showing you how you can link advanced design and advanced steel to design and detail your steel projects. So as you see, it's an entire program. An entire agenda. My webinar was the first one of this week, so it's not too late. You still have time to register to the following sessions tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Now it's time for me to close this session. So I see that there are some questions. So I can try to answer a few questions, but don't worry if I have no time to answer all questions. I will answer per email. Here you have my coordinates, so do not hesitate to contact me per mail directly on my LinkedIn account. I will be more than happy to answer your questions. Okay, so I see that someone has a problem with the synchronization mechanism on Revit 2019. So it's Melanie. So Melanie, I suggest that you can push me an email and we will try to see what's happening on your computer. Also, I see another question. When we synchronize, it will accept all the elements or it will create duplicate elements in Revit. That's the power of our synchronization mechanism. First, we do not duplicate. So it means it's you as a user who can decide to accept the synchronization. So it means to replace the existing object in Revit by the new one, and not replacing the object but updating the properties. So it can create a new object that was not in Revit, but it can also, for example, update to the type if you have changed the section, update the boundary condition. So it depends, and it's really you to decide. For example, you don't, because I know some other synchronization mechanism where you have no choice, you have to synchronize everything in one shot. That's just not possible. Here, you can do it, of course, but we know that the real workflow is not like that. It's that you can work just on beams, just on columns, and then synchronize on selection per type of elements and so on. I have also another question, if there is a French version. I don't know if you are speaking about the webinar or the software, maybe both. So obviously the software exists in French, of course, in French language with the French norms, no problem. And the webinar itself, so we are playing this first webinar in English for a wider audience, but soon we will duplicate those webinars in French language. Don't worry. Okay, so okay, it's time to finish. So again, please, if you still have questions, do not hesitate to contact me. Take a picture of the screen, keep my my coordinates, and feel free, please, to ask. Also, if you are interested, I also invite you to connect to our corporate website, where you will have dedicated product web product pages on advanced design, on the power pack with a lot of details, sometimes small videos to discover the different features we have. You will be able to download a trial if you want to try the software. And you have also all our contacts. So if you want more information, if you want a demo, you can contact our local representatives on this URL here. You have all the contacts depending on your country. So I'm just checking if there is a last question. Yes, okay. So I see someone who is asking if it's about a certificate. So unfortunately, this webinar is not really a training. So we do not deliver certificates for this webinar. And to answer the last questions, and then I'm finishing. Yes, this webinar has been recorded, and all the registered people will get the link to access the recorded video. And for sure, we will post also the videos on our YouTube channels. So follow us also on YouTube. Thank you very much, everybody. I'm sorry, I'm already out of time, 10 minutes longer than expected. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks again, and have a good day. Bye.